Our topic of presentation is bottom-up parser, code synthesis, and vertical bit. And the contents of the presentation are parser, bottom-up parser, code synthesis, bit, vertical bit, and example problem of the vertical bit, and few gate questions as well. So starting with parser, parsing is a process of deriving a string from a given grammar. We use CFG here, context-free grammar. As we know, lexical analysis is the first phase of compiler. Lexical analyzer breaks syntaxes into series of tokens, and parser takes token string as input and converts it into the parser tree. Parser is also known as syntax analyzer. Now we have two types of parser, top-down parser and bottom-up parser. Top-down parser, the parser which generates parse for the given input string with the help of grammar productions by expanding the non-terminals, that is start from the start symbol and ends on the terminal. It uses leftmost derivation. Top-down parser can be further classified into two types, recursive descent parser, which is also known as brute force parser or backtracking parser. And the second type of top-down parser is non-recursive descent parser, also known as LL1 parser or predictive parser, which uses parsing table to generate the parse tree instead of backtracking. Now coming to bottom-up parser, it starts...
Bottom-up parser is a parser which generates the parse tree for the given input string with the help of grammar production by comprising the non-terminals. That is, it starts from non-terminals and end on the stat symbol. It uses reverse of the rightmost derivations. Further, bottom-up parsers are classified in two types, which are LA parser and operator precedence parser. First is LA parser. LA parser is the bottom-up parser which generates the parser tree for the given string by using unambiguous grammar. It follows the reverse of rightmost derivation. LA parser is also further classified as four types, which is LR0, SLR1, LALR1, CLR1. Now, the second type of bottom-up parser is operator precedence parser. It generates the parse tree from given grammar and string, but the only condition is two consecutive non-terminal and epsilon never appears in the right-hand side of the any production. Now, code synthesis. Code synthesis is a system software development company with a focus on build systems, object persistence, domain specific languages and their mapping, compiler design, code generation, and source-to-source translation for the C++ programming languages.
Control unit is agent that performs and runs all functions of computer with the help of control signals. So in microprogrammed control unit, the control signals are stored in special memory units. And set of control signals are called microinstructions, and the microinstructions are stored in internal control memory. So the microprogrammed control unit can be divided into two types based on the type of control word stored in control memory, and the types are horizontal microprogrammed control unit and vertical. So in horizontal microprogrammed control unit, the control signals are represented in the decoded binary format, that is one bit per control signal. Here, n control signals require n-bit encoding, and on the other hand, vertical microprogram control unit, the control signals are represented in encoded binary format, and here n control signals require log n bit coding. In vertical bit, it supports shorter control word, so, and it makes more use of ROM encoding, so the length of control word is short, and it allows low degree of parallelism, that is the parallelism is either 0 or 1, and it is slower than horizontal microprogram control unit but more flexible than horizontal. And vertical microprogram control unit uses vertical micro instructions where a code is used for each action to be performed, and the decoder translates the code into individual control signals, and it makes more use of ROM code, as I just said earlier. And additional hardware is also added in the form of decoders to generate control signals.
Consider a hypothetical control unit which supports 4 keywords. The hardware contains 64 control signals and 16 flags. We need to find the size of control word used in bits and control memory in byte using number 1 horizontal programming and vertical programming. So the solution will be, for finding the size of control word in bits and control memory in bytes using horizontal programming will be control word size equal to 4 plus 64 plus 12, which is equal to 80 bits, and control memory will be equal to 4k word, which is equal to 4 into 80 divided by 8 equal to 40k bytes. For vertical programming, the control word size will be equal to 4 plus 6 plus 12 equal to 22 bits, and control memory will be 4k word, which is equal to 4 into 22 divided by 8 equal to 11k bytes. Which of the following derivation does a top-down parser use while parsing an input string? The input is assumed to be scanned in left-to-right order, which is a gate question of CS2000. And the options are A, leftmost derivation; B, leftmost derivation plays out in reverse; C, rightmost derivation; D, rightmost derivation plays out in reverse. And the answer will be top-down parsing, leftmost derivation, LL. So the explanation will be, in top-down parsing, we just start with the start symbol and compare the right side of the different production against the first piece of input to see which of the production should be used. The top-down parser is called LL parser because it parses the input. Second question. The process of assigning load addresses to various parts of the program and adjusting the code data in the program to reflect the assigned addresses is called: option A, assembly; option B, parsing; option C, relocation; option D, symbol resolution. It is typically done by linker during compilation at compile time, although it can be done at runtime by a relocating loader. Compilers or assemblers typically generates the executable with 0 as the lower most starting address. Before the execution of object code, these addresses should be adjusted so that they denote the correct runtime.
Okay, the third question is, which of the following statements is false? Okay, this has come in GATE exam 2001. First option, an unambiguous grammar has same leftmost and rightmost derivation. B, an LL1 parser is a top-down parser. Option C, LALR is more powerful than SLR. Option D is, an ambiguous grammar can never be LR for any K. So let's look for the answer. The option is A. The correct option is A. If a grammar has more than one leftmost or rightmost derivation for a single sentimental form, the grammar is ambiguous. The leftmost and rightmost derivation for a sentential form may differ, even in an unambiguous grammar. Okay, Ayush, can you please change the slide? The fourth question is, an optimizer compiler is dash. Options are, is optimized to occupy less space. Option B, is optimized to occupy less space and optimize the code. Option C, optimize the code. Option D is none of the mentioned. Answer will be D. Explanation is, in computing, an optimizing compiler is a compiler that tries to minimize or maximize some attributes of an executable computer program. So let's move forward.
Very good presentation, particularly. But the thing is that the vertical programming, I liked it that Shivangi has told. Even before that, your presentation is very neat.